What we're going to do today is take you through a start to finish using a digital impression system, digital design, and we'll mill out a restoration and just show you what that workflow looks like. So even if you send in a traditional impression to us, that impression gets poured up and immediately digitized. You can see the technician using a benchtop digital scanner, scans it into software where they then design, creating the contours, creating the contacts, and from there, that design proposal gets transferred to a milling system. So the initial design is the CAD portion, a computer-aided design, and then now we're entering the computer-aided manufacturing, the CAM portion of that process. You can see here the universal robotic arm reaching for one of the blocks, depending on which shade is required.
So here's the case. I'll introduce you to the preparation here. It was a porcelain-fused metal restoration on tooth number 30 with open margins throughout. So we're going to go ahead and first certainly remove the old restoration, and that you saw I was fitting in the IsoDry. It's a nice retraction and isolation tool. And then here's a screwdriver type instrument or a Christensen removal tool to separate that mechanical bond from the coping, that metal coping, to the prep. Here I'm using a flowable. I like using flowable for a lot of situations to adapt well to these different irregular surfaces, particularly on these buildup areas. It adapts well. And then now we're going to refine the preparation. So I typically, for gross reduction, use a coarse grit green stripe diamond burr. Again, axially it's a round ended tapered diamond burr. Occlusally it's usually a football or a rounded diamond burr. Once everything's smooth, I do the probe check to make sure all the margins are connected, as you can see here. So that wraps up the introduction to the case. I'm going to move over into the operatory, so if you can hang tight for a couple minutes, we're going to get the patient ready, and I'll introduce you to the clinical situation. We're going to place a retraction cord, and then we'll get the digital impression scanned, and I'll show you some cool features with the iTero.
So we're going to try a size 3. I know we go up to size 3 as the largest board, so I'm going to try that with just a little bit of hemostatic agent on there. So when we place the cord, I like to try to first seat it in interproximally first. So on the mesial or distal area, usually that's, you know, it sounds like a really large size cord, which it is. And again, visualizing from an occlusal aspect, we want to try to be able to see the margins and the axial surfaces together from that top-down view. All right, so we're gonna jump over to the iTero now, and I'll show you the setting up of the prescription.
So the digital impression, it's kind of like a digital triple tray. You're gonna pick up the preparation, you're gonna pick up the quadrant that the preparation's on. In this case, we're gonna get prep 30 first. The scanner with the iTero gets a higher resolution scan of the preps, just a little bit more detail. And then we're going to capture the rest of the adjacent teeth. I like to go all the way up to the canine, and then the opposing, and then from there we're going to bring those two models together with a bite scan with the patient biting fully and centric. All right, so this first scan will be of the preparation. So with the iTero element, you're going to rest the camera down on the teeth, and you can see the crosshairs there. All right, so we've transitioned to the iTero. So you can see the crosshairs. I start off on the occlusal. Once I activate the camera with the button on the body of the camera, I then begin rotating to the lingual. And it's almost a hard rotation to 90 degrees. All right, so now that we've completed the scans, we're going to advance to the third page on top. And this is our post-processing, our prep evaluation stage, and we can take a look at our impression. We want to evaluate the margins. We want to evaluate whether or not we have the adjacent surfaces of the contacts. So again, just like with your digital pictures, if you see right away that your picture is blurry, or you got the wrong angle, or you didn't actually capture what you wanted, same concept with this digital impression, taking the image, evaluating it. It's so powerful to see your work right away. Again, a little bit humbling at first. You some dentists shy away from wanting to see their prep so magnified, but I guarantee you, promise you that it would make you better when you can see your work right away. So now that we have our digital impression, we've got the prep, adjacent teeth, opposing, and the bite, that digital triple tray. Now we're gonna transfer that digital impression to our digital design station, which is in the lab right next to us. So if you can hang tight for a couple minutes, I'll introduce you to how we would design a case using Fast Design. All right, so we're in our lab. We have our chairside workstation here, our design station, and our milling unit. I'm gonna open the file that we just transferred over from the digital impression system. And now that we're in design, so we have our design here. I'm using the mouse to control, so we have our digital control of the rotation and zoom of our preparation. I'm just gonna start off the margin placement there. So I just give a single left click, and you can see how the software begins trying to identify, so it's kind of an automated process. And again, the software has no idea where the margins are. That's why we need to tell it where to begin placing it. So this is designating that start point of our restoration. It's so critical. And it's just basically going until we reach that starting point, that original starting point of the margin placement. So now, now that I made that click on the mesial lingual area, the software completes the placement of the margin, and now you see we have a couple of figures, some arrows that appears over the prep. So now we have our initial proposal. So the artificial intelligence, it does expand and using a library that's embedded within the software to create a proposal that fits the space. So let me show you here, we have our lower model, but I can bring the opposing out. So we can further evaluate how this articulation is for the patient. And again, for the purposes of this presentation, I'm gonna mill out a camouflage material. So this material, camouflage, it's a resin hybrid material. So it's 80% ceramic, 20% resin. Once it's locked in, I shut the lid down and press okay. And now it's going to initiate the milling cycle for this particular case. It's a full coverage crown on 30. And this will probably take about 8 minutes to mill using this material. And we'll talk more about the differences in the materials now. So we'll head back to the patient and then we'll come back and grab this crown once it's done. Looks like right out of the mill. So this is the metal mandrel and the restoration, of course, and that connection piece is the sprue. Just to show you what it looks like from the milling box, I'm going to show you side by side what one of the blocks looks like pre-milled. So again, this is a pre-centered zirconia. So again, that means it's already gone through that curing or centering cycle processing of the material at the laboratory. And so when it mills out, it's already in that high strength, 1200 plus megapascal flexural strength. So it's the same strength that you would get from the laboratory. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and seat this down. All right, normally, interproximal contacts, I do like to use a shim stock, very thin piece just to make sure it doesn't tear. But here we're just gonna check it with floss. We certainly do wanna have contact. This is probably the most universally used method to check contacts, but and compare the differences between these blocks that we have available. Just really quick, we have the camouflage that we milled out. Of course, we have Bruxer. So the Bruxer material, that's the centered zirconia. That's meant for posterior full coverage cases. And by request of our existing users with the system, they love having the ability to mill a centered zirconia chairside. They've requested an anterior block. So an anterior block would be a taller block to accommodate those longer teeth in the anterior. So we are currently developing a even more translucent and more aesthetic Bruxer material for the anterior. That's coming out soon, so that's going to be pretty exciting to have. And you can see it's this is the only material that's in this shape because of that centered nature. And if you're curious about the strength of the material, it's just as strong as the material that you get from the lab. And so right now the system can be used on any single unit situation, posterior, anterior, partial or full coverage. The highlight material certainly is Bruxer. Getting to do a Bruxer high strength material centered zirconia chairside, and that takes about 35 to 40 minutes to mill because of that high strength state. But the thing is, right out of the oven, which here we have our polished zirconia crown that we did earlier, it's ready to cement. So because of the high strength nature of it, you can use a conventional cement. If you like using Reli Excluding Plus, like 3M's resin modified glass ionomer, it's a really easy to use cement, or Ceramir. You can just slap whatever you normally like to use into the crown and it works very well. But there is an option if you want to bond that in as well. The other material is obsidian, depending on the size of the restoration. Takes about 12 to 15 minutes to mill. Camouflage, usually less than 10 minutes because of that resin nature to it, and the biotemps is not far off, less than 10 minutes if you want to mill a quick provisional for your patients. Are you enjoying this instructional video? I hope so. If you'd like to receive additional clinical instruction with AGD and ADA approved CE credits, all at no charge, be sure to visit glidewelldental.com/education, where in addition to over 60 on-demand clinical courses, you can also access our weekly webinars along with other valuable content. So we have a couple minutes left. I think we might have some questions. So we have Dr. Manalili here that will be presenting later at 1 on guided surgery, but I think she has some questions.
Yeah, so we had some really great questions come in over the last couple hours. So thank you guys. Unfortunately, we don't have time to answer all of them. But leading up to kind of what you were just talking about, the Bruxer, can you talk about maybe the differences between the Bruxer that comes out of the mill here versus the lab Bruxer material?
Sure. So the difference between Bruxer from the lab and Bruxer now that's milled in the fast mill chairside, there's actually not much difference in the strength. The formulation is exactly what you would receive from the laboratory. So it's going to be upwards of that 1,000 plus megapascal flexural strength. So strength-wise, there's no difference. And I know there sometimes is a concern. I do get questions about microfractures through that milling cycle. But zirconia has this amazing property, which is transformational toughening. So it actually doesn't receive a lot of microfractures. If for any reason it did, it self-heals. So it's actually, we've done a lot of tests internally to determine the strength, to see that it is actually what we're getting through the lab, and the strength is on par. If not, actually, some of the samples were even stronger than what we got through the laboratory.